I'm born and raised in Tampa. Lived here pretty much my whole life other than college. And I always knew that I wanted to start a business in the area, something that really screamed local. So Michael and I went to Florida State together, college fraternity brothers. So we would take snowboarding trips pretty much every year. One of our snowboarding trips in 2015, we got to talking about craft beer and opening a brewery. Michael was living in San Diego at the time.
We had a couple of friends who had branched out and started small breweries in the area. So we started looking at it from a business standpoint. Do the numbers make sense? The failure rate? How are these other small breweries doing? And we started looking around San Diego for a location. We looked for a location in San Diego for about 9 months. It was just a really tough fit. There's a lot of competition in the area.
He asked if I'd be interested in looking into opening a brewery in Tampa. Originally at the time, there wasn't nearly as many craft breweries as there are now. So I was like, you know, let me do some homework on it, look into it, and I'll get back to you.
He came back and said, you know, I don't exactly understand it. It's not what I've been doing, but these people are doing big things. These people have a lot of growth. There's a big buzz around here. Yeah, this could work.
We kind of decided that over the course of that trip that, you know, I was gonna come back and we were gonna start looking for space here. We're gonna go for it. We're gonna try and open a craft brewery in the Tampa Bay area. That's kind of how it all, you know, I guess started. It was really just an idea and a conversation snowboarding.
So the process really depends on the beer. Obviously, there's different techniques and different processes that go into each style. But you know, your basic process is for every beer, no matter what, you're gonna mash in. So you're gonna mix grain with water, extract that sugar out of the grain, transfer it over into the boil kettle where you mix in the hops for bittering, flavor, aroma. And then from there, you send it off to the fermenter where you then add and introduce the yeast. And from there is when you gain that alcohol, and that's when it actually becomes beer. And then again, you sit down at the end of the day and you enjoy that beer.
81 Bay is a name that we came up with in college. A bunch of my fraternity brothers were all from Tampa as well. And we were, you know, some night after a long night of drinking, we had been out at a social, and somebody kind of just threw the name 81 Bay out there, you know, like I believe they said my boy K from the 81 Bay. I was like, 81 Bay, it's got a good ring to it, you know. And it was a play off of, you know, the area code 813 in Tampa Bay. So it's kind of a merger of those two things. We wanted to, you know, pay homage to the Tampa Bay area, and also incorporate that into our logo. So most people from Tampa will look at our logo and realize that there's a 3 in the B, and most people that aren't from the area don't really catch it.
So the creative process of brewing is that's what I'm very passionate about. Getting up every morning and thinking about what's going to be the next big beer that I'm going to brew. And the brewing industry isn't super competitive, but the competitive part in me of wanting to outdo the guy next to me or the guy across the street or something like that, and making myself better every day and learning new processes and learning new techniques. That's why I get up every morning.
The most rewarding part for me about having 81 Bay is I enjoy creating environments that people enjoy themselves more than I enjoy enjoying that environment myself. Just sitting at the end of the bar, standing at the end of the bar, when we're busy, and looking around the room and watching people enjoy our beer and people enjoy each other's company, and that's the most rewarding part for me.
The most rewarding part to me is, I mean, obviously the beer, definitely the beer. You know, I was saying earlier about how we come in every day and we put a lot of hard work into it, blood, sweat, and tears sometimes, and when we sit down at the end of the day and actually have that finished product and see what our hard work led to, that's very rewarding to me.